Good morning, y'all. It is about to be 10 a.m. and I just finished reading a few of the comments of my previous video, and y'all are hyping up the baby bangs, which makes me feel so good because I thought I made the wrong move, but you guys are saying that it just elevates my look a little bit more. And really, I was just scared to show off my eyebrows because I don't maintain them very often. Like, when it comes to threading or waxing them, I get so lazy about it. Also, they're just a little bit uneven, so I have always tried to live behind the saying, eyebrows are sisters, not twins. But I feel like now it won't even matter. Well, it won't matter next week because that's when I plan on bleaching them. But I just think it's wild that I actually get a lot of compliments on my hair, and little do people know that it's actually one of my biggest insecurities. It's mainly my forehead and my hairline, just because it is like pretty uneven and wonky. And at the top, the hair is pretty sparse, so I've always had bangs to just hide that. But I have gotten help from MD Hair. They're the world's first medical grade hair growth treatment that's customized for your specific hair growth needs. We're gonna massage that serum in, but all you really do is just take their quiz and then complete their scalp picture analysis, and then they make products just for you. All of their products are also clinically proven, so they're developed by dermatologists, and so they're formulated with medical grade ingredients and botanical formulas. But the quiz is super easy to take. It just asks you about your hair goals, your health goals, your hair texture, your hair type, and just how often you shampoo. And then you literally send a photo of your scalp and they analyze the photo, your answers, and then based off that, they create a customized hair growth kit for you. So this is what mine looks like. It comes in recyclable packaging. And of course, we have our shampoo and conditioner. This cleanses and stimulates the scalp for hair growth. And when I tell you that this smells so good, and it smells like it comes straight from like a luxurious bougie salon. And then we have the hair care serum that I applied earlier. And ultimately, this helps with scalp repair and regrowth. I also have some wellness supplements. So if you have like high stress levels like me, this just provides all the right vitamins and minerals so that it promotes natural hair growth. Lastly, and the most important, is collagen. This helps with thicker, stronger hair and healthier nails. I'm gonna show you guys these up close, but they're so bad. But I am guilty of damaging my nails by ripping off my Gel-X nails. But MD Hair did come through with the discount code, so you can get 70% off your first monthly kit with full size products if you use the link down below in my description box and use code TWINL70. But one of the perks of having really long hair is doing this at the end of the month. Okay, let's go choose an outfit. I have an outfit that looks good in my head, and I'm hoping it looks just as good on the body. And surprise, surprise, it involves another camo skirt. So we have this skirt that I've been wearing, not even kidding, the past 2 days. And I think we're gonna keep it neutral. I've been wanting to wear this vest for a minute. And because I'm on my period, I do need just a little bit of support under my skirt. So I'm thinking maybe these lace shorts. This is what the outfit is looking like. I'm okay with it. It's already so hot, so I don't even wanna bother choosing another outfit. I just can't decide. Should we do white cowboy boots, or should we do some buckled black boots? But let's just talk about what we're doing today. We are headed to a new thrift store, like a literal new thrift store that just opened up about 2 months ago. I was just scrolling on Instagram, and then I came across a sponsored ad for Public Estrellas. And in the bio, they have both Spanish and English, so I'm assuming that it's Latino owned. And then I checked the address. It's only 10 minutes away from me. And even better is that they are having a $5 sale right now. Literally everything in the store, only $5. So I don't feel like we have much to lose. Let's go check it out, and I'll let you know if it's worth it. So
I don't totally know my LA geography, but this trash can over here says that we're in Lincoln Heights. I thought it was East LA, or is that the same thing? I don't know, but we're right across the street. So even from their Instagram post, it does look pretty curated, but let me bring it a little closer. They have that sandwich board that's advertising their $5 sale, so let's go check it out. So literally everything on hangers here on the floor is $5, except for things that are hanging in the air. I think these are more the exclusive items, so they are gonna be a little bit higher in price. But for a new thrift store, these prices are not bad at all. We're gonna start off with this seasonal rack, just because look at all these prints. I usually don't like polka dots, But why am I so obsessed with this? It just looks so dang cute. It's the brand Liz Lisa. And I feel like with bloomers underneath, that would look freaking adorable. And for $5, you know what? I'm gonna have to hold on to her for sure. What's so funny too is that I usually don't like vintage, but something about my upcoming trip to Paris makes me just wanna wear so many cutesy feminine pieces like this. So I already know I wanna wear these with Mary Janes and some cute frilly socks. Just came across this cute little bolero. It's black. I love all the texture to it and it's mesh. Oh my God, that's so freaking cute. What's this? Another little lace piece, but I think we're gonna leave her. Ooh, do you guys see that lace trimming? This looks very promising and very pretty. Ooh, what is this? Okay, this is pretty. I don't know if I like this elasticized waist. Oh my gosh, what is this? Sub and Kiss? I don't know if that's the name of the brand, but this looks very pretty. Maybe we'll just try it on because my hands are getting a little full. Y'all, I cannot resist a good faux fur collar, but it is summertime in Los Angeles, so I'm absolutely gonna be passing on that. But look at all the blazers they have. I wanna get through these dresses though. Look at what Arthur just found. Those are awesome.
Those are so cool.
Wait, I love that. It says Denver, San Francisco, a whole bunch of Chicago, like states and cities. Hey, what size are those?
It's a 76.
76, what the heck does that even mean? I would say hold on to them. I do want to try those on for sure. They're kind of giving me trip, but like maybe the swap meet version. I'm not too sure. So Arthur knows that I've been on the hunt for a moto jacket. I did pick one up in France, but I kind of want like a pink or a red one. And he says that he found one. So let's see. Oh, this is thinner, huh? Oh, that's kind of cool. Usually the ones I come across are like super structured and you can barely move in them.
Yeah.
Oh, I feel like this one might be a little too tiny, but it looks awesome.
Yeah.
I'm not a big fan of the color purple, but this shirt is pretty awesome. It's totally mesh, has an all over print. Oh, I'm tempted to take this, but I know it would probably just sit in my wardrobe. So I think we're gonna pass on that. This is giving major witchy vibes. That's pretty cute. They have so much lace here. Oh my gosh, the way that I've been looking for a pink jersey, but I'm thinking more pastel. This might be a little too obnoxious. I only have 6 items so far just because the weight of the hangers freaking hurts, but I do want, oh my goodness. There she is. That's the dress that I saw on Instagram. Wait, let's go look at her. So for a minute, newspaper print was all the rave, and I actually have a shirt that has like a wired neck that I was gonna wear today, but I ended up passing. And this is so cute. Okay, we might have to get that down and just check the tag, because if it's a paper tag made in USA, I'm probably gonna take her. Okay, let's get these tried on though. Look at the fitting rooms, they're so freaking cute. I feel like I'm totally contradicting myself because I was just talking about how I don't really like the color purple, but look at this dang dress. This is total goals. This is so damn cute. And then look at the little details with the velvet ribbon. Come on. That's so dang cute. And it's only $5. It can't get any better than this. Oh no, 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 no. This is doing nothing for the body. I tried it on just to give it the benefit of the doubt because it looks really cute on the hanger, but I think we're gonna pass on this one. I really appreciate that this place has fitting rooms because I feel like they're unheard of now in Los Angeles, but good thing I tried this on because my boobs are so squished in this. It is really cute, but I can't even zip it from the back because my shoulders are so broad. But oh, so sad to leave this one behind because it's so cute. And I feel like the hem hits me in a really perfect place. So I totally appreciate that everything is sorted into categories, it's on hangers, but this right here, this is what's like most exciting to me just because you're able to rummage and you never know what you're gonna find. But they said that this was the unsorted section, so not sure if I can actually rummage through this, but I mean, This color looks cute. The lace looks cute. They've got some faux fur over here. So can't wait to see this on the sales floor. The amount of jerseys that they have here is nuts. Not only this double rack here, but over here in this section, all of those are jerseys too. So look at this. This orange one is catching my eye. I love this, but I kind of want something with sleeves and maybe even cropped. Oh my gosh, wait. I actually really like this, but it doesn't have sleeves. I'm stuck. Granger Raptors. Oh, this is fun too. I could only imagine this with some like jorts and then some braids to put in my hair. They also have this one. Major Football has a horse. Number 14. This is kind of cute. It would fit more like a baby tee and cropped. I'll think about this one. They've got a little tie section over here. Let's see if we can come across any cool colors or prints. Oh, I kind of like this one. Anything with plaid really catches my eye. But other than, I thought it would look a little bit cuter. I think I'm gonna pass on this, but I do like how slim it is. I think I saw that it was 28 online. Yeah, but looks like it might be a little oversized, but yeah. I'm gonna try it on.
Still try it on.
Yeah. So I don't see a paper tag on here, but the brand is BB Aroma Bamboo. It doesn't feel like the greatest quality, but I'm pretty sure that's not fast fashion. It also looks a little oversized, but let's at least try it on because we never know what it'll fit like. I have my skirt on underneath, so it's giving extra volume, but oh yeah, this is not doing it. It does better fit like a large, extra large. So in the pit area and bust, it's very loose. But other than that, it has a really fun hem. It's kind of like asymmetrical. We have a cute little vent here and it has little lace black trimming. Aw, I think we're gonna have to hang her back up. I don't know how we missed this one. But look at the lace, the ruffles. And it has satin bows on the straps. Oh yeah, we had to try her on for sure. Y'all, how I wanted this one to work so bad, but my hips are just too big for this. I think it is supposed to be like very bodycon, but no, my hips are screaming in this. But look at these details. So if you need this in your life, it'll be here for you. One thing I did notice though is that they don't have a lingerie or slip section. So that kind of sucks because I'm always on the lookout for them. If you're a size 20W, you need to run and come grab this because look at the lace-up detail. It has the belt and flare legs. Oh, this is so good. I totally missed this, but they have a cute little shoe section back here. Let's see if anything catches my eye. Looks like they have a lot of sneakers, dress shoes. Let's see. Nah, nothing today. For the most part, all of this is women's clothing. And then for the men's, sadly, it's just t-shirts. I mean, Arthur loves that, so good for him. But I mean, if you are pretty adventurous with your style and you can only fit into men's clothing, there's not very much variety. And then back here, they have all the winter wear stuff. So I think this might be sitting for a hot minute because it's pretty hot in Los Angeles right now, but they give you options.
Y'all, I had to take those clips out of my hair because they were just falling. And now I have these bubbles, so don't mind those, but we are back from Public Estrellas. I have a lot of thoughts. I did walk out with 4 items, but really 3 of them are for me. 1 of them is for Arthur. So let's talk about the clothes first. So one item that I picked up is this black bolero. I recently sold one that I had in my wardrobe, actually. It was a black lace one. I sold it on Whatnot, but I think I like this one even better just because of the frills. It has a lot of texture. It's mesh construction. And I was looking at this tag and this has Asian characters. I believe this is Japanese, but all I could make out is Ichiyoku. That probably sounds so bad in American. If you can read this though, let me know because I'm not sure if it's like, you know, a cool Japanese brand or whether it's like some sort of fast fashion. I also wasn't trying to get black clothes just because it's starting to warm up here in Los Angeles, but I couldn't resist. I could not leave that one behind. And then y'all saw this dress. Oh, so I'm doing it again. Colors that I wasn't really trying to pick up were black and purple. But like you saw this, this was so dang cute. I love the plaid print. It has the little velvet details. I was looking closer at the silver hardware and I think they're coins. And the brand for this one is Milk, but the tag on the inside again has Asian characters. I can't make anything out, but it does come with a little additional coin button on here. So it says that it's half a franc, which I feel so ignorant, but I don't know what country or countries uses francs. And the quality on this one isn't the greatest, but I feel like the details and the tool really make up for it, and I can't complain too much. I only got it for $5. They had a crap ton of jerseys in there. It was hard not to walk out with one. So we'll start off with the one that I got. It's this yellow one. It says Beckon and it has a number 7 on it, but I especially liked it because it's a little bit more boxy, it's cropped, and it comes with a hood. So I feel like it's pretty different from like other styles that we've been seeing right now. And I love that it's lined. So it's definitely a top that I can just wear my bra on underneath and not feel like too revealing. But then I looked at the size and it's size F, which I was just like, okay, what does that mean? And then the tag on the inside again has Japanese or Asian characters. And the only thing I can make out is a website, which is www.wego.jp/. So I looked it up, but the pictures of the inside of the store kind of remind me of Forever 21, H&M. And then I saw an article that if you ever do go to Japan, apparently Wego is one of those stores that you absolutely have to shop at. So if this is from Japan, I do think it's pretty awesome. All I need is some boxer boots to top off the look. The last item I have to show off is Arthur's, and it's another jersey. I really like this one because it's black and white, so it'll go with like a whole bunch of outfits and colors. I just think it's so funny because he always thrifts items that have things that we don't do. Like, he has this t-shirt that he constantly wears that has a Marlboro logo on it, and we don't even smoke cigarettes. And now he has this one that says Jack Daniels, and we don't drink Jack Daniels, but you gotta admit, this one looks pretty awesome. And oh, I didn't even notice that. His has a 7 on it, mine has a 7 on it. So I love that we're gonna be able to be twins, but for all of these items, we only spent $20. I'm not gonna lie, but I was a little disappointed when I heard that the owner of Public Estrellas is not Latino. The girls working there told me that he's Middle Eastern, and so at first I was like, aw, damn it. Okay, but then as I was thinking more about it, I feel like he has a really awesome business model and I really hope that it lasts. So if you're unfamiliar with Lincoln Heights, they have a really big Latino community there. Something that I really appreciate that he's doing is that he's hiring from within the neighborhood. So the two girls who are managing the store are Latinas, but one of them is specifically from Lincoln Heights. The second thing is that the prices are so affordable, so it makes it actually accessible to the community. And even better is that it's entirely curated. The last thing I really liked is that their signage and social media is in Spanish and English, so this just goes back to being accessible but also being mindful of the neighborhood that they're in. And if you're just like, okay Danielle, we get it, you wanted it to be Latino, you're proud to be Latina, yes, but I feel like this is just so important to me because there's been a handful of times where I've walked into Crossroads Buffalo Exchange on Melrose, and as soon as I walk in, they look at me up and down and don't even greet me. So it makes me feel super unwelcome. Just makes me wonder if it's the way that I look, the way that I'm dressed, and it's just a really uncomfortable environment to shop in. But I'm rating Public Estrellas a solid 8 out of 10. I just knocked down 2 points just because there wasn't very much that caught my eye or that I wanted to drop money on, just because they didn't have very much Y2K and they didn't have an ounce of lingerie. But the store was super clean, the workers are super nice, so if you want to check it out for yourself, I'll have the address down below in the description box. If you do end up going, let me know what you end up picking up. If there's another thrift store that you want me to check out here in Los Angeles, also drop it down below in the comments. But as always, y'all, I do post videos at least once a week. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!